Hey, what's up, guys? I'm Praetorian.
And Jinx here.
And welcome back to Prison Simulator on the PlayStation 5. Alright, so we're picking up right where we left off in the last episode, where we're trying to search for the second missing fuse. So we just need to look around everywhere. I should just be on the floor somewhere.
It sounded like someone was following you.
It was just the door closing. No worries, Jinx.
I'm scared.
The lights go off and Jinx gets terrified.
Yeah, I expect ghosts.
Jinx is a real scaredy cat in video games.
I'm just invested, okay?
She gets terrified, which is why whenever we do play horror games, which is almost never because it's difficult to get her to even play them, but when we do play horror games...
He's like, oh, I'm going to show you a trailer for this game that we're going to cover. And then I'm like, absolutely not.
Well, yeah, when we do play him, Jinx does the playing in those cases. Because she's just more invested in it, more scared. So this is the canteen. We've never been here. The dining facility or mess hall or what we called at our prison, the chow hall. And we call it the chow hall. I'm not seeing it anywhere. You notice there's still food all over the tables. I don't think that ever goes away. And it says we searched the canteen. Do we not need to go into the kitchen? Apparently not, but let's just check in here anyways. Though it did give us the check, so I'm assuming it's in the workshop. Probably should have searched there first. Though, I don't know, it might be random where it gets placed.
It's just in the last place you look.
Yeah, maybe it's in the last place you look. Yeah, you see we walked in here and it didn't get checked off. Alright, so we know for the future that if we walk in and it gets checked off, then it's not there.
We gotta go fondle everything.
Yeah, probably. But yeah, we know it's in here. Oh, there are cigarettes in here. Let's collect those. Alright, so we just need to look around. We can take these too. Oh, let me just pick them up. Like, can I put that in my pocket? At him. I'm not sure as how he got lost anywhere but right here. And maybe it is in there because the little light is. Oh, I thought I saw something right there. Maybe it's on the floor over there. But since we're back here, we'll just run over here and check real quick. Really, again, there's really no reason for it to be in here. Yeah, I think that's it right there. Actually, I see it. Yep, there it is. Alright, see, I probably just dropped out of his pocket when he was walking out of here. Alright, what's convenient is we're already in the workshop. So we can go and put it in place. Though they're all taken out.
I was about to say, where did the others go?
Okay, I feel like they need to go in certain places. Because you can see it says 1, 2, 4, 3. So I don't recall doing this in the first one. I know we did. I just don't recall what the order was. But yeah, I was trying to figure out how this goes in there. Like, we were rotating around, seeing if there was, like, a number on here. But they all look the same to me. See, we're just going to put it here. And it's got to have something to do with this. But yeah, I don't know, guys. So I guess we'll put it in here. Okay, so it lights up. So clearly that's not the right one. There we go. So there's got to be a difference. But we just don't know what they are.
We just can't tell what it is.
Yeah. All right, there we go. So we got the lights back on. That's what's important.
It's just a fuse.
All right, so now we need to report to the warden about this power outage. But you notice, like, all these officers in the prison and nobody seemed to care about the issue but us?
No, like, we're the only ones. Find a nap place.
Yeah, we're the only ones that are really dealing with it. Where are all the officers?
They're napping.
Yeah, they're all sleeping. The warden just woke up.
Yeah.
Alright, so the power's back on, but I couldn't finish my job. Have you got any intel for me? So, sir, the cause of the temporary power outage was Kenneth Lahey from Block B. I guess you were supposed
to
be.
That's so. How did he get to the fuses?
He probably broke in and tried to take the chance and escape.
Understood. I'll get the papers ready in a minute. We have to let the higher-ups know. Looks like he'll stay here for a few more years. You're free to go for now. What time is it? I think it's time for a nap. I'll join you in a minute. I have to do something else.
You're going to join me in the nap, sir?
Yes.
Okay. I feel like there's
You've got a nap with your battle buddy.
I feel like there's a power indifference here. Like, I can't say no.
Because no, I'll get you fired. Can't.
No. I really want a nap with you, sir. All right, so that's the end of the day. It did take over the rest of the day, so we weren't able to do whatever else we were going to be assigned. But we did get increased guard respect, earned a little bit of money as well. How much was the next upgrade? Was it $50?
I didn't see.
I think that they're $50. Either that or 25, I don't remember. Might have been 25.
Oh, he's so sad.
We can go check real quick before we go do the parcel searching. And if it is 50, I guess we could just do a game of darts so we can get an upgrade. Yeah, I want to level up. Oh wait, no, that's not the right button, is it? We want to learn something.
What do you want to know?
So yeah, we have the remaining skill points, but it is $50. Is the first one over here 50 as well? It is. So basically we just need $10. So one bet here would be enough. Now, this guy sucks at darts so bad that I feel confident we could win him. Win against him for more money. And how much you bet will determine what the difficulty is going to be. So you can't do an easy difficulty if you're betting this much. And I think you have to do the hard difficulty if you want to do the top bets. Alright, so we're going to continue to hit here. This time we'll start from the beginning with the triple. And they got a little bit more difficult there. Alright, so we did not get the full points here. And I didn't do it there either. There we go. And he's going to do much better as well.
Oh, damn. He's good.
Yeah, he's now beating us. But again, there's really no reason to go for anywhere else.
He was hustling you the whole time.
Of course he was. He knew what he was doing. But I feel confident we're still going to win because unless he gets 60 every time, which you only see him do. Oh, damn. If you do the hard setting. So, I mean, we're still winning right now. And he's going for the low point ones. So I still feel confident we're going to win this. As long as we don't bust. Or mess up our math or something.
You are so good.
Wherever I want to hit, I hit, Jinx. Mostly. If only I was this good in real life. I'd be hustling the hell out of people. Oh, we only got 1 point left. Oh, my bad. I wasn't paying attention to the points, guys.
I'm just throwing darts.
Yeah, I'm just throwing darts, having fun. Well, we can still get the 1 point and not bust. Just need to hit right there, and...
Uh-oh.
So, we don't lose. They just give us a bunch more points.
Damn.
All right, so we actually need to pay attention to our points here, guys. All right, so let's do... We'll do the 60 again. And then we'll just try and get that 7 three times here. There we go.
Perfect.
All right, so we won the $30. Now we got 70 and enough to get ourselves a new skill. And so we're going to go after that passive one, the more health. I am tempted to try and get this one here, which I think you got to get the trust first. That might be better than what these passives are. Yeah, you know what? Let's just get the active ones for now, guys. Until it gets too expensive. Yeah, that's $100. I see.
Jeez.
So in that case, let's go with the health boost. Go and purchase that. We still have a skill point remaining, but we are broke. So yeah, you could just sit here and play darts all day. And not do your job. And just earn lots of money. And I think that's the reason why they have the skill points. So you can't just, you know, get all the upgrades immediately. Alright, so now we have 4 boxes of crap we gotta go through. A bit more than last time. And everybody loves this book, apparently.
Got dirty pictures in
it. Yeah, I really feel like you need to, like, flip through the pages. There could be anything. There could be money in there. which money is a hot commodity in the prison, more so, obviously, money is something that everybody cares about everywhere, but even more so in prison because it's hard to get.
Some yucky old canned food.
Now the... Oh, we found something finally. Chicken this is the first time tits. We found something. So, how do we... There we go. So, some pills. So, let's go and secure that. So, now we really need to pay attention to make sure there's nothing else in here, because they already tried to sneak something, so we know they're up to no good. We have the, Oh, yep, there's another thing. Wow. Just stabbed right in there. How would that even fit? That
doesn't make any sense. I don't even know.
Alright, so they're trying to stick a syringe in here. Let's go and secure that now. So yeah, lots of contraband in this one. He really shouldn't even get it. I feel like you have contraband in here, it's just everything should be forfeited.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so let's go and close this baby up. Can we pick it up without closing it? No.
Like, you a bad, bad dude. How are you gonna lie to us?
Which guy is this? It's George Lewis.
Fucking George. You ain't getting shit, George.
But yeah, since cash is so hard to get into the prison, that's typically not what they deal with. Whenever they're, that's not what their economy is based off of. In our prison, the economy is based off of stamps. And, you know, we tried to deter it by making them write their... Oh, we found something again. Everybody trying to sneak something. We found some joints.
Just gonna hang on to that. Trying to get high up in here. Albacore tuna.
But yeah, we tried to deter it by making them write their TDCJ number, which TDCJ stands for Texas Department of Criminal Justice. But yeah, we tried to deter it by making them write their TDCJ number on all their stamps. In fact, stamps that didn't have a TDCJ number on it were considered contraband, since again, they used it as money. And they're required to put the number on there. And then if they have anybody's, you know, if they have any stamps that has anybody else's number on it, then those can be taken as well, since they clearly were trading with them. But yeah, I really didn't deter the use of them.
These are some weird deodorants.
Well, they said it's shampoo on that one thing.
Oh, true.
Unless whichever guard wrote that it was shampoo just doesn't know what deodorant is because he doesn't use it.
He's a bald guy. He's like, I don't have shampoo. I don't know what that is. I don't need it.
Yeah, but I mean, like, he would still know what deodorant is, right?
No, he wouldn't.
Yeah, because he doesn't use it.
Where are we in the country, exactly? Are we in Kentucky?
I think it's just kind of open. I'm not sure, though. It might have stated somewhere where... Oh, actually, you know what it did? I think it said, like, when we were looking at the top 20, it did say for the state, so maybe it said the name of the state. We'd have to look at the computer again to confirm. And there we are, another joint.
Gonna have a bunch of drug parties.
So yeah, the majority of boxes that we went through today had contraband. Alright, so it looks like that's it. Let's go and close it up. And then we're done. Alright, so... I was trying to figure out why we lost money on that one. And I realized, I think it's because maybe it counted us buying, well, you know, I'm not entirely sure. I was going to say maybe it counted us buying our upgrade, but that was $50, not 20.
Did we pocket anything?
No, I don't think so. Yeah, we didn't pocket anything.
I would have become a police officer.
So we're back on free time.
There's Purdy Boy.
No, the game's not here. All right, well, let's just do the workout. Improve some of our stats, guys. And wasn't this the stamina?
Yeah, I think so.
I mean, it doesn't make a whole lot of sense that lifting weights is stamina.
Hopefully it doesn't make you... Oh, you're going to do this?
Yeah, yeah.
I thought you were going to do the package again.
No, I was going to do the package, but it wasn't an option. Oh, well, now it's an option.
Huh. They just want you running all over the damn place.
Because, yeah, I wanted to get the speed so we can get around a little faster. But I suppose stamina has been an issue as well, and increasing stamina would make us better at this box running, because that was one of the problems we had. Alright, so we failed last time. So we're going to try and do it this time. Try and be more swift. I don't know why we have to go all the way in here, maybe because we failed it last time.
Yeah. Ready, all right, so. Go!
Are we going all the way to the back? It feels like we're not going as far. Yeah, this is going to be a lot easier. Again, we pretty much got the worst possible place that they could make us go. Oh, we do have to get... This is still counting.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so you have to hurry up and get in there. We got 2 speed from that. Alright, awesome. And we earned a bit of money. Alright, so next is the workshop task again. As I noted in that first episode, you know, when you're playing early on here, it will feel like you're doing the same thing over and over again.
Because you kind of are.
Well, more tasks will open up. Though doing the same task over and over again is actually pretty accurate for prison.
Or any job.
Yeah, really for any job, I suppose.
Don't be
so
me.
We're not bringing you, Jinx, because you hit yourself with a hammer last time, and we're going to bring a different gang.
Just so you know, it wasn't me.
So...
You call me banging on the...
let's bring the lions. I don't know if we want to bring Ray Dorian, but... Ah, whatever.
A whole life with idiots.
Come on, Ray Dorian.
Aren't you a nice fella?
And he's got a mission. That's what the exclamation point stands for. So he's got like a mission for us.
You do missions for prisoners?
Yeah, you can. Mm-hmm. We're going to bring him as well since he's a lion.
He was taking a poop.
He had his pants on, Jinx. I think he was just using it.
Fella, we got work to do.
I feel like he was just using it as a seat.
Kevin wore makeup?
Yes.
Oh, geez, Leo.
We'll bring Leo as well. And...
Why are you looking at my pecker? Lynn.
And I'm looking for the last lion here.
Are you going to bring the whole gang?
We're not bringing Peter Johnson. Yeah, my gang rolls all together, Jinx.
Oh, I see how it is. But I got to get beat up all by myself.
Beat up? You beat yourself up with a hammer, no. Jinx. This guy's got...
I don't think that's what happened.
This guy's got this up here.
He likes cars.
We haven't done any prison... any cell searches yet. I'm surprised we haven't done it yet. There's Kevin Shepard. Where's our other lion? Configures is the last one I look at.
Robert.
Although he wasn't... Oh, yeah, he was. Okay, Svensson. All right, so let's go ahead and put this away. And then rally. Or no, excuse me, follow me. All right, so let's get them all over to the workshop. And get this done.
Gonna go stand around pretending to work on things.
This is going to probably... There's going to be some fighting. I already know. And I guarantee it's going to be Praetorian. It's going to cause a problem. You see that this cop here also has a mission for us. We could talk to him real quick.
He's just got to go to the bathroom. I got business. He says, can you do something for me?
I said, don't waste my time. It depends.
I need drugs yesterday.
Just drugs. Not any specific drug. Just any drugs. Drug. Yeah, we're not gonna do this.
Tell me if you find it.
He doesn't even care.
I'm itchy.
We're not gonna do all that. Alright, so we need to...
Maybe he just needs hemorrhoid cream, but he doesn't want to say it in front of the inmates.
So he's like, it's just drugs.
He's like, I've got it.
For my butthole.
I've got a problem with my butt.
Alright, so I feel like Praetorian should be in the front here. So let's give him, and probably shouldn't give him a hammer to bash somebody's head in. That sounds like a horrible plan. Look at him yelling and pointing his finger at me. Like, who are you talking to?
Don't give him a screwdriver. Or a wrench.
We're going to give him the file, Jinx. How many people could hear with that,
give
right?
Give me a fucking thing. I'm going to go file the shit out of something.
All right, so we'll give him the file, and then I don't know who this guy is. Let me just see here. What's he in here for? Animal cruelty. Well, there's no animals in here, so he should be okay with the knife, right?
He's in there with bear, Praetorian.
So we'll give him the knife. And then this guy here is in here for breaking into bank accounts. He's also not in a gang. So let's go ahead and have...
Nice knife guy.
Him get the wrench.
Or screwdriver.
Yeah, we could have given him the screwdriver. Alright, and then... I guess he can have the hammer. I didn't see what he was in here for. Participatory ritual gang rape.
No screwdriver for him.
This is a robbery assault with fatal outcome.
You brought Kenneth?
So,
I thought he was a squid billy.
Who? We didn't bring Kenneth.
Oh.
He hates Kenneth.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, that's Robert Svensson.
Be careful, Praetorian.
Alright, so need to keep our eyes on these guys.
Somebody's gonna shank you.
Make sure they're working. Tell me the lions are a good crew that aren't gonna cause any problems.
I don't think so.
It seems like whoever...
It's not me, it's the hammer.
Oh, hold up.
Praetorian, what are you doing?
Hey, whoa, whoa, buddy. Trying to talk to him first.
You gonna beat up your own guy? Oh, that's not... No.
No, that's...
Yeah, that's not your guy.
So we gotta take them both out. So we won't have anybody in here because everybody's knocked out. We're gonna fill up the infirmary. We'll have a... Three new inmates ascend in there. So the rest of the day should be pretty easy. There's only two inmates left in here.
Nobody to watch.
Okay. So I was like talking shit. Like, oh, watch the lions be real easy.
They're the worst.
Yeah. And then this guy's not even working. Come on, buddy.
He's like, I like the curvature of them legs.
He was just thinking. That's just all. So it happens, get back to work. But we're not going to get any respect for doing this, unfortunately. Because he's going to go back to work. So we're not giving him a break.
I would be like, just don't stab anybody with that, and we're good.
So he's another lion. So we actually have two of the three lions in here, Jinx. So it was just me who got kicked out. The lions seem like a pretty good crew, honestly.
Like, we don't.
Like, they're not trying to get in trouble. Jim here, you know, he's here for animal cruelty. He's probably a. Doing some pretty horrible things. He deserves to be in prison, but he's a neutral character. He has no respect for us. He hates Daniel Goldberg.
That's my dude.
Oh, is that your guy?
I think so.
But yeah, we have had no issues with him so far. And then this guy might, Robert Svensson might kind of zone off a little bit, but... Robbery, assault with fatal outcome. It happens. You're just trying to rob somebody and then, you know, somebody dies.
Accident.
Yeah. But he's harmless. He's harmless. All right, so we'll let him work the maximum amount of time to get the most money here. And then we'll get them all called in. I wonder if they have to work longer, though, because you have less inmates or if you get less money or something.
We're not actually building chairs here.
Because, yeah, there's really... There's nobody in here. We've lost 60% of our workers. But yeah, they're both working hard.
I don't know about working hard.
You're just salty.
Sure.
Because the lions are a good group of guys.
Sure.
Other than myself.
Except for the leader.
Except for the leader, yeah. All right, so let's go ahead and gather them up. Rally them. And we won't have to search for any people. There's only two here. Yeah, I'm surprised that these are the ones who decided to join the Lions. I feel like Praetorian intimidated him to get him into his gang. They didn't even want to be in his gang.
They probably didn't.
Just got intimidated into it. Did I get the tool from? Alright, so this is his task that we don't want to do.
He's like, I'm being beat up.
I need the tool for you, man. Okay, yeah, we got them. All right, so let's go and get these all placed back, and then we'll do the search. But yeah, only two people to search. Nice and easy. Oh. We found... Oh, our controller's gone dead. We found a needle on him. We're going to go ahead and secure this. It's for his medical needs. Yeah, we're not going to let...
Like a sewing needle. He's gonna make himself a dress.
That's what I was thinking originally, but yeah. He says it's for his medical needs. So we're gonna confiscate it and lose respect. I don't know. What do you think? You think we should use an opportunity to get some respect over a needle?
No. If it was a sewing needle, maybe.
Wasn't that what kind of needle it was?
I mean, that's what it looked like, but he's saying it's for his medical needs.
It didn't look like a syringe. I think those are called syringes on here.
True.
Maybe he just needs to, like, sew up his cuts or something.
Sure.
If we all never let the inmates make it, then they'll all hate us and we'll have constant riots. So it's one thing to consider. Oh, yes, we forgot to search this guy. He's got a chocolate bar. I kind of want to take it. I'm hungry. But we're going to let him make it. Alright, so let's get them following us and bring these guys back. Oh, and we're gonna start a fight.
Box somebody?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'm in a fighting mood, Jinx. Alright, so let's get these guys brought back to their cells. And then maybe we'll be able to do maybe one more task before the end of the episode. They're so slow, they need to do some cardio. Jesus, he got lost on the way. Alright. So we're back on free time. I see. Well, I feel like we need money. So we could also use the stamina as well. So you know what, actually, let's go work out real quick.
Are you gonna punish Praetorian?
Oh, for starting a fight?
Yes.
I should've.
You should've.
But he was knocked out, Jinx. I don't think you can do that now at this point because they gotta have the thing over their head. But because he got knocked out, we weren't able to punish him. And you can't do it in here either.
Wow, okay.
So because he got knocked out, I guess
he made it.
That was his punishment.
That was his punishment, yeah. Was getting a little bump on the noggin.
And then getting to sleep in the infirmary and harass the nurse.
Yeah. Wow. Wow.
Well, you've been in the infirmary twice already, Jinx. I kind of feel like...
I'm only there for the jello.
Uh-huh. I kind of feel like you're in there for the nurse.
Well, she likes me because I'm nice.
Uh-huh, I'm sure. I'm going to harass her.
I have a beautiful, beautiful beard.
All right, so we could have tried to earn some money from this. Oh, do we have to do more reps now?
Ooh.
Seems like we're doing more reps, right? Didn't we have to do like 11 last time?
Yeah, you getting strong. Working on your fitness. I don't think
that one was good enough. There you go.
Ooh, look at you go.
Let's see, yeah, this does take a little while.
Jeez, you need a bunch of them.
Last time we came here and started doing this workout, we were talking about Jinx and me our workouts. Well, this guy's gonna come over here and smash my head in while I'm doing this.
Praetorian's strong.
Yeah. Everybody looking at me.
Ooh.
But yeah, I've been getting pretty big, guys. Damn, I can't get this last rep. I do not do 14 reps. I prefer doing more weight and less reps. I like doing the reverse pyramids. Is my preference. So starting out high and then going down from there. And just trying to do more reps. So we gained 20 stamina. Alright, so that was a 20% increase. Yeah, that was helpful. But yeah, I typically go down by about 15 pounds. And I think that's what you go down by as well, right?
Yeah.
And so yeah, we drop it by 15 pounds for each set. And then just try and do more reps. So I guess we'll be releasing prisoners. This is a pretty easy job here.
We got a good workout today. I'm exhausted.
Today was full body day. We try and do one full body workout every week. I got to take Donald, his box here.
Does Donald get to go home?
Yeah, he's supposed to be going home.
He doesn't have a home.
So now we need to search him. Don't want him bringing contraband outside of the prison. Check the documents up.
Donald.
So now we're just going to confirm these here. Yeah, those are good. Let me go and check his name, although we can see that's good.
He's a drug smuggler. You got to check his booty hole.
He's getting out of the prison, Jinx. He's
taking drugs out.
You just want to check his booty hole. What is wrong with you?
Spread him.
And you can tell that Jinx is not the one who's ever worked as a prison, because if she had been, she would be having PTSD right now from...
all the booty holes I'd seen.
Yeah. You're over here causing me problems and stuff. I'm over here stressing out. Like, please no. I don't want to see it. Alright, so that's going to call him over here. Yeah, when I was working in the prison, I had to work the visitation several times. Not in the visitation. Unfortunately, they only let the females work in there just because they want to. And... so they get to work there, and they never let the dudes work in the visitation because it's such an easy job. And so, yeah, we never got to... the men never got to do that. If you got put on the visitation, then you looked at buttholes. That's what you got to do. And also, the females can't strip search the inmates. They can pat search, but they can't strip search them. So they couldn't even work in that area anyways. We need to search them next. I'm all looking for his documents. Like, where the hell is this guy's documents at? But yeah, when you do that...
He's also a Podolsky.
Oh, are they getting out together? Oh, that's interesting. Oh, wait a minute. Well, I just said it couldn't compare, not that they're wrong, but there is... Nah, I guess there's really not any differences here. I think it's fine.
True.
Oh, wait a minute. It says no match.
Which one doesn't... Oh, is it one of the details? Yep, the date.
Oh, is that what the issue is? Well, yeah. The date is always going to be different, Jinx, because that's the true. Date that the fingerprints were taken. The number is right.
Oh, it says it's right now.
Yeah, but it keeps lighting up. I'm really not seeing the difference just looking at it. They look exactly the same to me. I don't know. I kind of feel like that thing is not working.
Yeah, lied.
Yeah, I don't think that's working. Well, I think this is fine, guys. Just looking at it, they look fine. Let's just go ahead and stamp it. I know we're letting a guy out, so this is kind of serious, but... So now we need to call the guard.
He's whistling. That's suspicious.
Maybe he's just really happy because he's getting out of prison, Jinx. Oh, wow. We're letting a lot of prisoners out today.
Jeez. Gonna wreak havoc on the town.
Mm-hmm.
You couldn't have put on a shirt, fella?
Nope. Oh, Helmut Lewis is getting out. Alright, so Svensson has one less enemy. Did he? I thought he's the one that hit himself in the head or something with the hammer.
Well, I mean, I think he did, but he was out in the yard.
He got knocked out. Okay. Was he in the fight, though?
I don't know
though?
That he started it.
Well, let's make sure that these are all correct. Again, we can do this, but...
These are Podolsky's prints.
Yeah, these are like the same prints, aren't they? Yeah. Do they all have the same prints?
Yeah,
they do. All right, I'm not seeing...
Suspicious.
Anything wrong here, guys. We can go ahead and confirm the dates, or excuse me, the names and the numbers. 24, 64, 52, we're good. Name's good. Everything else is good.
Okay.
So these guys are getting out, and thus we'll have to bring new inmates in. So let's just stamp this.
Stamp.
But yeah, when you work the visitation as a dude, they have you work in the back, and thus every inmate who comes out of visitation has got to be fully strip searched. You got it. And you do need to look at their bowels, because while they're sitting down, the person visiting them will hand them things, and then while they're sitting there, they'll be shoving it up their butthole.
Oh, wow.
And yes, I have caught people trying to bring stuff out of visitation.
In their buttholes?
In their buttholes,
oh,
yeah.
Oh, God, no. Mm-hmm.
In their mouths, in their buttholes, the bottom of the feet, armpits, and in the armpits.
Oh. Yeah.
Pretty much everywhere where you might be able to hide something, they have to attempt it to. But yeah, you see so many buttholes when you wear visitation. It's ridiculous. It's over today. And then also, if they need to go to the bathroom, you got to strip search them then, too.
I'd be like, you're not going to the bathroom.
You got a lot of guard respect today. But yeah, it's a horrible. I only had to do it a few times. Visitation was only on the weekends. And generally, they would have the part-timers do that. Because they only work the weekend.
It's like, yeah, you're only here for a short period of time. Let's make a high number of your percentage looking at buttholes.
I felt bad for this one guy. He had lost his mind. Like, I worked with him a couple times, and he had clearly lost his mind doing strip searches. Because he was the only part-time male. And so we only needed to send...
That's all he did.
That's all he did. All weekend long, every weekend of his life.
Oh, geez.
For like 10 years, he had been strip searching inmates.
No.
And so when you worked in visitation as a dude, you worked with him. So they only needed one dude back there because he worked. He did one of the... Because you always had to have two dudes back there. And so he did one of those roles. And then we'd need to take one of our officers from somewhere to work that.
Oh,
so
God.
You very rarely ever did it when you worked full time as I did. But yeah, he worked there all the time, every weekend. And he was...
That would be awful.
There's something wrong with him. He was out there. And I think it's from looking at naked dudes all day, every day, 2 days a week.
Jesus.
Yeah, so pretty terrible situation for him.
There is such a thing as too many assholes, apparently. Mm-hmm. I wonder what number it was.
The taint jinx. That's the other place where I found somebody putting something.
Like, what is the threshold?
They taped it up on the taint.
How many assholes does it take to make you lose your mind?
Good question. And we'll answer that question on the next episode. So, what were you going to say? One would be enough for you?
One would be enough for me. I'd be like, I don't think this job is for me.
Yeah. So, I hope you guys did enjoy today's episode. If you did, make sure you leave a like on the video, subscribe to our channel, hit that notification bell, and leave a comment. Do hope to see you guys on the next one, where I guess we're going to be bringing new prisoners in to replace those prisoners that just left. Just looking at the rest of our schedule here. So we're doing that, free time. We're going to do our first cell shakedowns. And then we're going to clean the prison, which is some BS. Because officers don't clean anything in a prison. They have
we got to do it?
Yeah, they have the inmates clean everything. But in this game, the officers clean it. Or specifically, the new boot cleans everything. And then we have to do an evening headcount, which I don't know that we've done an evening headcount yet. I think they've all been the beginning of the day headcount. But yeah, we'll do all that in the next video. So I'll see you then, and thanks for watching.